tonight, I watched my daughter's last water polo game.
Number one, Brianna Moyer.
It symbolized the last time she would jump into the water on a competitive high school water polo team. But most of all, it symbolized the end of an era. Sounds silly? Maybe. But when you're the mother or father of an athlete, it's the closing of a chapter, a milestone.
Number eight, Jenna Stain, senior.
My daughter played organized sports since she was 5 years old. We survived the daily dropping off and picking up from practice to practice. The countless times we put uniforms of all styles and colors into the washer and dryer. There were the meals on the go because she had only 20 minutes between water polo practice and soccer to eat and change in the car. It was a routine. It was a fact.
Number 10, Mika Howe, senior.
It was simply a way of life. And now it's over. Tonight, we heard her name and number called for the last time.
Number 15, Margot Fattusi, senior.
A rite of passage, if you will. She was a young woman now, no longer a young girl. Our baby was all grown up, and this was her last hurrah, and she did it proud.
Number 16, Stephanie Valdez.
So when the last ball hit the net and the buzzer sounded, she heard the crowd cheer for the last time. But it didn't matter. It was a great effort. I can't even tell you how I felt. A myriad of emotions came over me. Tears ran down my face. I smiled looking at her and waved, quietly thanking her. For just a moment, she looked like a little girl again. But of course, a beautiful and talented young woman waved back to me. I don't know what came over me, but all of a sudden I jumped up. And with unabashed pride, and with thanks for all the special moments and memories, I applauded and let out a cheer for the very last time.